Hello everyone, here with another enhancement video, this time taking a look at stats and the big shiny legendaries we're going to be getting in Legion. As always, Alpha is Alpha and things may change, but this is what I have gleaned from it so far, so bear that in mind if you're watching this a bit further down the line. Anyway, let's just get straight into the stat discussion first. Let's start with Mastery, that has been changed and is now giving obviously the regular elemental damage that we already had, but also a very low but scaling chance to generate Stormbringer and Wind Fury from our main hand attacks. Stormbringer is the Stormstrike cooldown reset and also has quite a few artifact perks that interact with it, making it quite an interesting dynamic scaling stat that affects all of our damage now instead of just the elemental damage when it comes to our active tools. Mastery then bumps our burst and our cyclable cooldowns by keeping Stormstrike available as often as possible by giving us those procs and those resets. But it also still has the really massive AoE damage implications because Crash Lightning is still completely elemental, as is Fury of Air. So we still have got the incentive to take Mastery for AoE, but now we've got a bit more of an incentive to focus for it on single target, especially the further into the artifact you go when you get some of the perks that directly interact with Stormstrike and Stormbringer particularly. As of now, from what I've been able to see with the spreadsheets that I've been doing, Mastery is as good or slightly better, depending on talents, as Agility, which is a bold statement to say because classes that have secondaries that are equal to primaries is usually pretty extreme. But generally speaking, this is going to be your go-to stat unless something drastic changes over the course of the next few builds or by the time this actually reaches live. Haste is no longer the powerhouse reduce all the cooldowns aspect, given that we aren't as reliant on cooldowns and are more focused on the resource gen that we have in WOD, but it still is a useful stat. It directly scales our resource gen by giving us more auto attacks, which in turn also increases the opportunities for us to get a Wind Fury or a Stormbringer proc. So it does scale dynamically with your mastery as well. So it is definitely the secondary stat, if you want to put it like that. So still one that we're going to be looking at. It does push also more global cooldowns for us to be able to spend the excess maelstrom that we get during particularly high periods such as Doomwinds or Feral Spirits, which at both times we do have quite an excess, and it is quite difficult to really push out all the globals that you want to keep yourself from capping. At the moment, Haste and Mastery, still the two best stats as we have had in WOD for different reasons now, and Mastery is absolutely the prime unless something very significant changes. Crit and Verse, still very weak, very average. They're just flat damage increases. Verse has the slight added bonus of giving you a little bit of extra DR. But the two of them, they don't have any mechanics or anything particularly extreme that make them any better, so you shouldn't be really worried about whether or not you have them. It's just an afterthought at the moment. Moving on to legendaries, this is entirely conjecture, as we can't test any of these, and it's solely off taking the tooltip and applying it to what we know so far with current enhancement gameplay. As such, this needs to be taken with a colossal grain of salt until any of this can be confirmed, and anything regarding stats on the items versus competition pieces you could possibly equip in the same slot is obviously not going to be counted here because, again, that is really something that we don't know whether or not it's final. Anyway, without further ado, let's move on to the legendaries. First is a neck, which is a defensive neck, called Zavarix's Magnum Opus. This is a free absorb when you don't take damage over a certain period of time, which I believe is 5 seconds. If you do that, then you get a 30% flat shield for the next attack that you're going to take. This is, generally speaking, a good defensive item because as a melee, unless it's pulsing AoE or something that you have to get hit by or soak, you're going to be able to build this up so you've got that 30% absorb quite often in a fight. And getting those frequent 30% absorbs, that's a lot of damage taken that you're going to reduce because the health pools have increased a lot in Legion. Talking in a general sense from the raid testing that I've seen, you're looking at anywhere from between around 400 to 800k, depending on how much stamina you've built up. Unfortunately, since it's a defensive and you're a DPS, actually finding room to equip this over, say, some of the other DPS items that I'm going to be going over now is the more difficult option. So I can't see this being the primary option unless it actually does let you negate mechanics that would otherwise be deadly and stop you from really progressing on a fight. Next is a ring, Cephas's Secret. This causes any CC applied, this is hard CC, such as roots, stuns, hexes, so on, to grant you a 70% movement speed buff for 10 seconds. Unfortunately, Enhancement doesn't have enough hard CC to be able to use this regularly, and quite often things are immune to hex, or you have to time your lightning surge totems if you've taken that talent to actually be able to hit, so it makes it, again, a lot less reliable. So this is one that I really can't see being taken, even though our mobility isn't excellent, it doesn't really address that issue. Next is the Roots of Shaladrassil, which is a pair of legs, which, based on the tooltip, give you a flat amount of health per 5 seconds if you stand still. This is 5% of your max HP, though this may be different, it may actually just be an effect on the amount of healing that you do, at which point that would make it significantly worse than it already is. But given that as a melee you don't stand still very often, and that's not just including your Twitch stutter steps that everyone seems to do in melee, we're talking like avoiding mechanics, staying on targets. These are not things that you can sacrifice for the sake of a bit of extra healing. You will die, and especially given that our defensive cooldowns are few and far between, it's a big sacrifice to take that risk so you can get a bit more healing afterwards. Definitely not one that I can see us using. Next up is another ring, the Eye of the Twisting Nether, which was previously the Diablo 3 reference to Talrasha. This is a 2% damage bonus per different element used in your attacks for 10 seconds. This does stack, so obviously we can get Fire, Frost, and Nature as enhancement. This is a good bonus because we use all of those if we take certain talents. However, if those talents are taken to make the best use out of it, it's not as likely to gain the same benefit as the legendary I'm going to talk about next, because you are required to take Hailstorm to make effective use out of this ring, and the next has a direct increase, which is very significant from using it. That next legendary then is Akainu's Absolute Justice, which is a 60% increase on your Lava Lash damage if you have Frostbrand and Flame Tongue active at the same time. This is a very, very high bonus to your single target by beefing up your Lava Lash. It brings it very close to a Storm Strike hit, although artifacts again do diminish that effect because it has no synergy whatsoever with this other than your Forged in Lava flat damage increase on Lava Lash. It is, however, still the most active and apparently most strong single target legendary that you're going to be looking at. It doesn't have any effect on AoE, though we will be looking at one that does later on. So, generally speaking, this is one of the ones that you're going to see get used in the current state. Although, I personally think that it is likely that it could see a number retune unless all of the others get brought up, because that is a massive damage buff to Lava Lash, which also has quite a significant impact on your general gameplay and rotation, and how much you want to actually spend that Maelstrom on a regular Storm Strike, as opposed to just a Stormbringed one, which obviously you're going to hit without any question. Next is Storm Tempests. This causes Storm Strike to debuff a target to zap extra other targets that are next to them for a small amount of nature damage. Based on the tooltip, this requires two targets to take into effect, and is extremely weak because of that. The number tuning makes it so, because the actual damage that it's firing off based on those tooltips is really, really, really bad. And especially since in two targets, you're already going to be trying to maximize your cleave damage from Crash Lightning and all of the other factors, that you're not necessarily going to be worried about this debuff and optimizing it by tab targeting. Arguably, this is one that I could imagine getting some sort of rework, or at very least some sort of number tuning to bring it up. But until then, not really one that you should be thinking about. Next is the AoE legendary, which is Emelon's Charged Core. This gives 10% base damage if your Crash Lightning hits 3 targets or more. This is a great increase, because whenever there's AoE or cleave, your Crash is going to hit 3 targets. And especially when you're taking other AoE talents, beefing that up for any small amount of window is going to have a big effect on the amount of damage that you do, how much burst you can actively do, and your overall cleave damage, boss damage, any situation where you can actively abuse Crash Lightning's cleave effects. I'd imagine that this could then see the most amount of use, second only to Akainu's Absolute Justice, as mentioned before. Those are the two, though, that I am looking at very strongly for the DPS aspects when it comes to the Legion legendaries. Last on the list is Spiritual Journey. These are a pair of boots they give a 75% upgrade to the cooldown speed of Feral Spirit while you're in Ghost Wolf. It's quite a weird bonus that you need to sacrifice your active damage because you're going to be sat in Ghost Wolf to speed up your primary cooldown. But at the same time, it has got the potential to have some really interesting mechanical effects. Being able to get your primary DPS cooldown active faster at the cost of your damage. So in fights, say, Iskar or Archimonde, where you need to be able to get that burst out really quickly, if you can just sack your damage to be able to pull up that cooldown to burn things more frequently, could have some use. But at the moment, the biggest problem with this, unfortunately, isn't even the item, it's just that Feral Spirit is not that great. Once Feral Spirit receives a buff, or they become a bit more of an impactful, punchy cooldown, then this item could also be really, really good. It will just need a lot more active, clever use to really maximize it. But it's definitely one that should be on your radar, along with a couple of others that I've mentioned. Okay, so that's all of the legendaries covered. Again, being alpha, any of this could change, and when we test them, any of the things that I've said could end up just being completely wrong, because we have no idea whether they work as they state they do in the tooltip. So I'd wait with bated breath, but I've been asked a few times to look at the legendaries, so this is what I think of them so far. Lastly, guys, sorry for the delay on the videos recently. I've been busy keeping the docs up and the spreadsheets that I've been getting working for Enhancement in Legion for the future. And a few other things have also taken over, such as the new Diablo and Hearthstone seasons, which slowed me down. But as always, massive thanks for watching. And also, you can catch me during the raid tests on the Legion Alpha on my Twitch stream, which you can see linked in the description below. So I hope to see you there, and if not, I'll catch you in the next video.